मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। माई सेल्फ सूरज कुमार सोनी एंड दिस इज़ द पार्ट नंबर 3 ऑफ द चैप्टर मेटल एंड नॉन मेटल ऑफ क्लास 10th साइंस। इन द लास्ट वीडियो वी डिस्कस अबाउट द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ मेटल, प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ नॉन मेटल, देन सम केमिकल रिएक्टिविटी ऑफ मेटल, देन रिएक्टिविटी सीरीज, एक्सट्रैक्शन ऑफ मेटल एंड दिस इंपॉर्टेंट थ्योरी चैप्टर्स वी थ्योरी सेक्शंस वी हैव डन इन अवर लास्ट वीडियो। नाउ द टॉपिक इज गोइंग ऑन इज एक्सट्रैक्शन ऑफ मेटल फ्रॉम द लो रिएक्टिविटी सीरीज देन मिडल रिएक्टिविटी सीरीज। ओके, दिस टू टॉपिक्स वी हैव डन, बट इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट एक्सट्रैक्शन ऑफ मेटल फ्रॉम हाई रिएक्टिविटी सीरीज। ओके, एंड सम इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक लाइक रिफाइनिंग ऑफ मेटल, वॉट इज अ कोरोजन एंड हाउ इट कैन बी प्रिवेंट। से नाउ स्टार्ट extraction of metal towards the top of the activity series, extraction of metal from the middle series, middle activity series and low reactivity series we have done, but in this topic listen how we can extract the metal from the high reactivity series. The metal at the top of the activity series like potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium, they are the highly reactive. They cannot be obtained from their compound by the heating with the carbon. These metals have the more affinity for the oxygen. Okay, they cannot be obtained from their compound by heating and the carbon. Okay, these metals have the more affinity for the oxygen, and these metals are obtained by the electrolytic reduction. Okay, these metals can be obtained by the electrolytic reduction. Sodium ions are migrate to the cathode because cathode is negative, where the electrons enter the melt and are reduced to the sodium metal. Chloride ion migrate to the other way towards the anode because chlorine is negative, anode is positive. They give up their electron to the anode and are oxidized to the chlorine gas. Okay, means sodium metal shifted towards the cathode and chlorine ion shifted towards the anode because anode is positive and the cathode is negative. And sodium metal is positive and chlorine element is negative. Now look at that, this is the electrolysis process. In this process anode is positive, there is a beaker and beaker contain two electrode, anode and cathode. Anode is positive, cathode is negative, and this beaker contain the NaCl solution, that is called barium solution. And this NaCl solution, when we pass the current, then NaCl ion dissociate and form the Na plus Cl minus ion. Na plus shifted to cathode and Cl minus shifted to anode, and current flow from the plus to minus, and the electron flows from minus to plus. So by this process we extract the chlorine and sodium and calcium chlorine. Okay, so this is the simple method, and by this that process sodium metals deposited on the cathode by the reduction and by the electrolysis process. Okay, now refining of metals, a wide range of metals such as the copper, zinc, tin, nickel, silver, gold, etc. are refined electrically after obtaining them from their ores. Okay, metals are obtained by the ores. An impure metals is made the anode. Thin strip of the pure metal is made the cathode. Okay, a solution of the respective metal salt is used as electrolyte. Electric current is passed through the solution. Passing current through the electrolyte dissolves the pure metal from the anode into the electrolyte. Okay, on the other hand, the equal amount of the pure metal from the electrolyte get deposited on the cathode. Metal, pure metal is always deposited on cathode. The soluble impurities go into the electrolyte. Okay, the impurities are present, go to the electrolyte. Whereas the insoluble impurities settle down at the bottoms of the anode and are termed as the anode mud. Impurities, all the impurities are settled down at the anode and it is called anode mud. Okay, this is the process of refining of the metal from the high reactivity series, and this is called the electrolysis. Okay, this is the
टैंक दिस कंटेन द एनोड कैथोड, एनोड इज पॉजिटिव कैथोड इज नेगेटिव एंड एसिडिफाई कॉपर सल्फेट सोल्यूशन, दिस इज कॉपर सल्फेट सोल्यूशन. इन द कॉपर सल्फेट सोल्यूशन वैन यू पास द करंट कॉपर डिस सल्फेट डिसोसिएट इन टू कॉपर प्लस एंड सल्फेट आयन इन यू सी यू प्लस टू इन एस ओ फोर माइनस टू. कॉपर प्योर कॉपर इज शिफ्टेड टू द कॉपर इज प्लस सो इज शिफ्टेड टू द कैथोड एंड सो प्योर कॉपर इज डिपॉजिटेड ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ कैथोड एंड द इम्प्योर कॉपर और इम्प्योरिटी इज ऑल डिपॉजिटेड एट द लोअर ऑफ एनोड दैट इज कॉल्ड एनोड मड. क्योंकि दिस इज द एनोड मड. नाउ कोरोजन, वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ कोरोजन? आई थिंक यू अंडरस्टैंड वेरी वेल हाउ वी कैन एक्सटेंड द मेटल. नाउ द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज कोरोजन. कोरोजन कोरोजन मीन्स एनी मेटल वैन इज प्रेजेंट वैन इट रिएक्ट विद द एयर वॉटर मॉइस्चर इट फॉर्म द ऑक्साइड दैट इज कॉल्ड मेटल ऑक्साइड एंड दिस मेटल ऑक्साइड्स प्रेजेंट ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ द मेटल दैट डिग्रेड द मेटल एक्टिविटी सो दिस इज नोन एज द कोरोजन. एंड इन केस ऑफ द नाउ डू द थ्योरी ऑफ द कोरोजन. इन केस ऑफ द रस्टिंग ऑफ आयरन द आयरन रिएक्ट विद द ऑक्सीजन एयर एंड वॉटर इन द मॉइस्चर एंड डेवलप रस्ट दैट इज कॉल्ड हाइड्रेटेड ऑक्साइड. मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन Fe3O4 Fe2O3 आयरन रिएक्ट विद द एयर एंड वॉटर इट फॉर्म द Fe2O3 दैट इज कॉल्ड रस्ट. That is called rust Fe2O3 ferrous oxide. Okay. Now figure iron chain. You can see the figure in this diagram. This is the pure metal gold. This is iron chain. It with the air, oxygen, and the water. It convert into the rusting of iron Fe2O3. Okay. In case of the rusting of copper, the metallic copper react with the air, like oxygen and carbon dioxide. Atmospheric moisture and develop a green color coating of that is copper hydroxide. Okay, this is the again we can say this is the rusting of copper. In case of the trenching of silver articles, trenching means diminishing of the color. Trenching of silver articles, the metallic silver react with the hydrogen sulfide and sulfur present in the air and again tarnished. Okay, look at that. This is the polished silver. When silver reacts with the air and SO2 H2S gas, it turns into the silver sulfide. This is the this is called corrosion of metal. Now prevention from the corrosion. How we can prevent the corrosion? If we apply any kind of gel, oil, and grease, and so we can prevent the corrosion because after applying these type of substances, the metal surface will not come with the contact of the air and water. So following methods can be used for the prevention of corrosion. The first process is galvanization. Galvanization means method to protect the steel and iron articles from the rusting by the coating them with a thin layer of zinc. Means we can coated a iron by a thin layer of zinc. It is called galvanization. Okay, zinc layer is called galvanization. In case of homogeneous, this is the first method. Second method is alloying. Homogeneous mixture of two or more metals or a metal and a non-metal to change the property of the pure state metal and protect them from the rust. Again, I would like to told you, homogeneous mixture of two and more than two metals or metals or non-metals, okay, to change the property of the pure state metals and protect them from the rust, it is called alloy. Okay, from intense iron is used widely for different purpose, but it is never used in the pure state. It is always used in the fact that pure iron is very soft and stretch is not state, it is hot state, but mixing with the small amount of the carbon make it strong and the tough. Mixing nickel and chromium within the iron gives a stainless steel. Means we can say stainless steel is made up of iron, nickel and chromium, which is hard and that does not rust. Okay, means all the metals are, we use the alloy. Alloy is the mixture of metals, two metals and two metals and non-metals. So we can say we use the alloy. Why we use the alloy? Because for the prevention of the corrosion. Another method is, another vital property of the alloy is that electrical conductivity and melting point of the alloy is less than that pure metal. Okay, for instance, brass is the alloy of the copper and zinc. And bronze is the alloy of the copper and tin, and posing poor conductivity towards the electricity. On the other hand, copper is the pure state, is used for the making the electrical circuits. Means alloy the conductivity of the alloys is very less because the conductivity of the pure metal is very high. Okay, so that's why we use the alloy for the prevention of the corrosion. Now the last one is a musical instrument made brass and the left and bronze status statue. Solder is an alloy of the lead and tin. Okay, posing the low melting point and used for the welding electrical wires together. These are topics are left in your chapter, in this chapter, and we have done it. Now do the important questions. How we can extract the metals towards the top of the activity series? What is the process of refining of metals? What is the corrosion and what is the safety measure of the from the corrosion? This is very most important question. You have to dig in your notebook and we will check it, this question answer, after completion your after school reopen. Okay, thank you so much for watching this video, and watch again and again if you are unable to understand. Okay, bye bye, take care.